you know, to move forward. Because anywhere we go to out of Nigeria, we are second-class citizens.
Have you been able to relate with some of the ex-agitators who are currently within the amnesty program to find out if they can help with this new situation we have on the ground?
Yes, please. We meet from time to time. We discuss issues concerning way forward. Mm-hmm. And they are willing. They have dissociated themselves from this Avenger group so that we don't tag them to be one of them. Ex-agitators captured in the amnesty program are not involved in the amnesty in this Avenger group. That is why I am saying it is the area of pipeline vandalism and busting is totally discouraged. They should come up in the open to express themselves so that we can achieve win-win situation in this situation. I'm very concerned, I'm very worried, because I also come from that environment. Mm-hmm. It affects the environment, it affects their aquatic life. There's mass degradation in terms of environment happening in the Niger Delta region. That is why I totally do not agree that you have to vent your anger on pipes. Discuss the issue amicably and let us move forward as a country. Let's give the government the chance to revamp the economy, and then we should move forward as a country.
But you said that government is already in talks with them.
Yes, and this is how it should be, so that we can achieve a win-win situation and move on.
What do you say to those? I mean, some people have said online that the government is in talks with fake Niger Delta Avengers.
If the real ones are aware and they are true Nigerians, they mean well for Nigeria, then come up in the open and let us discuss and move forward. We just must move forward, because we can't allow this to continue. Like I said, it's not venting anger on pipes that will resolve the conflict.
What do you say to those who say that government is not sincere, you know, in how it's gone about this dialogue? That, you know, there are those who said that government initially said it asked for a 2-week ceasefire, and they kept their own part of the bargain, but they did not see any other step apart from the 2-week ceasefire that government itself had announced. And to show that they were serious, there was no bombing in those 2 weeks.
Good. How do you measure sincerity? You can't be looking at me and be doubting me. I'm open. My lines are open 24 hours. So send SMS or call and let's talk. Mm. You can't sit down and be doubting my sincerity. The government is sincere enough. What happened in Ogoni on the 2nd of June is enough sincerity that the government has to give to the people of Niger Delta that are sincere to ensuring stability in the region. There was a luncheon in Ogoni for cleaning up.
General,
if the government was not sincere, they would not meet up that timeline.
If we go just get back to Abuja and ask the special advisor, well, you did say that government is negotiating with the militants, even though conflicting statements from the VP. But why then do you think that the militants, MEND, over the weekend, reported to have given federal government 2 weeks ultimatum to resume negotiations, or they resume hostilities? What do you think informed that ultimatum?
Well, General, I'm sure that, you know, so the audio must have failed there, but my colleague was asking about the ultimatum issued by MEND over the weekend, asking government to resume negotiations with, or resume dialogue, rather, with the militants, otherwise they resume hostilities. Did you hear about that ultimatum that was issued over the weekend?
I heard about it, but the resumption of hostilities is what I'm concerned about. The hostility resumption should be discouraged. Everyone that is meaning right meaning for this country, and again, you don't use your territory as a battlefield. You should always create room for discussion.
How many groups are you dealing with right now? I mean, there's a Niger Delta Avengers, but MEND, it would seem, is saying that they will join the hostilities if this if dialogue is not resumed.
Yes.
Are you saying that there's no dialogue going on right now? Because you just already said that there was dialogue happening.
You see, dialogue is ongoing. Like I said, our numbers are open. People are meeting. I've also met with groups of persons from Niger Delta cutting across, discussing this issue of way forward. You know, almost everybody that comes along, they say they are stakeholders. Who is the stakeholder and who is not the stakeholder? It is all our concern to resolving this conflict. It should be every Nigerian's concern to resolve this conflict of Niger Delta. It's not only Niger Deltans. No. Because it's a conflict that has to do with our economy. And if we don't get it right now, it will be very difficult. So it concerns everyone. I'm very worried about what's happening.
Is there confusion within government circles as to which stance to take or not? Is the debate about dialogue still going on as to whether or not to dialogue with these groups? Is that still happening within government, especially if we're to go by the comments of the Vice President over the weekend?
The government have always said they're open to dialogue, and it is ongoing as a way to achieve this conflict. So the government is not saying to use coercive means to resolve it. They've said they're going to use dialogue as a mechanism towards establishing the conflict, and it's ongoing. So let's let the Avenger group give the government a chance to so that we can achieve a win-win situation and move the country forward. What is happening is affecting the economy, it's affecting the environment where it's taking place. So they should give the government a chance to move forward advancement in terms of developmental plans and activities.
You're certain, you're sure that that is the way government intends to go. I'm asking you in the light of, you know, what the Vice President said. If in one breath government is saying that, you know, they want dialogue, you know, and they're exploring the option of dialogue, and then the next minute, you know, government says, well, we think these people are criminals. They're not fighting for any agitation or struggle. They're fighting for their pockets, the people who are blowing up the pipelines. Doesn't that send a confusing message as to what exactly government itself is thinking?
Let me get it straight. Let me get it. Let me correct you now. Like I said, there are two groups now. We have those that are captured in the amnesty program, and it's ongoing in the program. We have those who do not believe that what is happening is right, and they go vent their angers on national assets.
What is happening?
This
how do you
is
mean?
Not acceptable. That's
what
the point I'm making.
Are you talking about when you say what is happening?
The pipeline vandalism.
Yes, I know. I mean, you said there are those who are not happy with what is happening. What are they not happy with?
No, what I mean is the Avengers taking it upon themselves to vent their anger on pipeline vandalism. To me, that is not the best way to resolve conflict.
General, I have to ask you to hold your thoughts, please. We have to take a moment now. Sunrise Daily will be right back.
Okay.